In our last video, we covered how to add labels to your parameters and the various ways to find the parameter you are looking for. In this video, we are taking a quick break from our planned schedule. Next time, we'll talk about editing parameters in bulk. Today, I'd like to talk to you about a recent enhancement we rolled out that is now available to all of you. In our video on creating parameters, we talked about the three methods of creating parameters in our service: manually, uploading your shared parameter file, or uploading a Revit file. Now, when you upload a parameter from a Revit model or template that already exists in the service, we will complete the available data for those parameters. This way, you can automatically apply category, type versus instance, and property palette group to parameters that originally were uploaded from a shared parameter file. Let's walk through this workflow. If you already have your parameters uploaded from your shared parameter file, here you can see which ones I've loaded by seeing the file name as a label, I can now fill in the missing data for my Revit template. I open Revit in the file that has the shared parameters loaded, then launch the parameter service in manage mode. I select upload and make sure that the active Revit model radial is selected. When I upload, I now get a slightly different message than before. I see the number of parameters that were uploaded. There is a success message that indicates the number of parameters that were updated. And I can download the report to see exactly what occurred. Here you can see what parameters were updated. While you can see parameters that were updated, you can also see what is skipped because it had data that was already defined, or it came from a different source such as a Revit file already, so it was simply skipped as a duplicate. Looking at the parameters we uploaded, you can see they now have their category binding set along with type versus instance and property palette group. Even better, the labels from the shared parameter upload are maintained. We only overwrite the fields that are missing. If you or someone has gone through and manually updated your parameter definition, we will not override the values. We think this change will allow you to have a simple workflow for fully building out your main parameter collection. You can upload your definitions from your shared parameter file first in order to get the groupings into the system as familiar labels. You can then upload your Revit template with your shared parameters loaded, or at least a well-defined project, and you will fill in all of the data instantly that used to take 9+ clicks in the Revit UI for each parameter. You now have a complete collection matching your existing company standard, ready to be round-tripped into any Revit project or family. You can also perform these actions with your families as well. If you have a family that has your company's standard for that type of family, you can upload its shared parameters to be updated in the service as well. A word of caution with families, however, please be cognizant of what family you are uploading, as you likely do not want to upload extraneous parameters, such as those from various manufacturers, to your company library by accident. If you do, make use of the archive feature to remove any parameters you do not want. In our next video, we'll explore how to edit your parameters in bulk. We will also continue to add short videos like this one whenever we release an enhancement.